Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a basic path starting from the 3D model of a part. This will be a very basic point-by-point approach to such a task, but I'm going to show you what I will show you later in a future video to create such a path in a matter of a few seconds. Let's see how it goes. So we start with the station as we left it. So we have our robot, a table, a tool, a part, which was just a box, and 4 points. I will delete everything within the frame, and I will delete program part here. Okay. In the folder with the files under module to create a RoboDK station, you have 0 to A cutting 3D. If you open this one here, you will find the intro station I've been using, so just kind of the demo finished station, but you will also find a cutting head.step, a cutting sheet.step, and a table. So as mentioned before, you can import in RoboDK either step file, IGES, or STL. We do accept other file formats, but I would say that those three are the most common, and if you were to choose, I would recommend using step. And then if you can't use step, use IGES. And if you can't use IGES, use STL. So I will simply drag and drop my cutting sheet part onto my frame part here. And I will make this one visible. So I have it here. Now it's kind of floating in mid-air because of the 50 millimeters I added for the cube, so I can double click here, enter 0 here, enter 0 in X and Y, let's say, and I can bring that closer. Let's eyeball that to something like that. It's in front of the robot. That should work for our example. Perfect. So if I was to get a project like that and I needed to cut out this piece here from a sheet metal, I would use a method that I will show you right away right now, so a quick method, but that's not the method I'm going to show you now, because I want you to learn to walk before you learn to run. Otherwise, if you stumble, you might stumble hard. So my goal is to show you a very basic method, because I need to kind of show you other stuff, other things while I'm showing you this basic method, but I still want you to be aware that there's a way faster way of doing what we're about to do. So if it was me here with the level of experience I have, I would go utility tools, I would go create curve, I would auto extract curve, I would extract that curve here, I would extract that curve here, this one here, I would do something like that and finish here like that. I would then go for utilities, curve follow project, select curve. I would select the first one, reverse the direction. I would go to select all. I would click done. I would show preferred tool path. Perfect. Update, simulate. And voila, I have my robot path. So I don't know how much time it took, but like, it's a matter of seconds. But I want to show you something else in this video, in the next few videos. So we'll go for a method that is a bit more hands-on, if I can say. So here, delete all curves. And I'm gonna bring back this frame, minus here. Okay, so perfect. I'm gonna bring that station here. So in the folder I gave you, there's one PDF file called part. So if you open this one, I'm gonna bring it here, you will see that you have all the coordinates of all the points are written here to kind of follow the silhouette of that part. I also added a 1 millimeter offset so that Let's say now it's a welder, but imagine that it's a laser cutter. Once a laser cutter, it has kind of a radius or diameter of the cutting tool or cutting array. So you need to consider that in your path. So that's what I did. So here we have one first point at -1, -1, another point 125, 41, -1, and so on and so forth. So we need to create those targets one by one. So it takes about 2 minutes. I'm going to show you how I would go to do that myself. So honestly, I would double click, not the tool, the robot. Would make sure that I'm aligned with the active frame. In this case, it's part. And I would start here by entering the values one by one. So I'm pressing tab to switch from one to the other. I'll say, okay, the pad, I'll put the pad at 4 millimeters in terms of Z here. So I create my first point at -1, -1. So if I press minus so that you can see, the TCP is here, target is here, -1, -1. This will be my first target. Then I will go ahead and move to the next one, which will be 125.41 in X and -1 again. Create target. Here we have 251 here, and we have 224.59, another target like that. I have here 251, another target. We move to the next one. We have 40.651, so create another one. The last one we have one and -1 and 210, create another target. So this is our intermediary point to create a half circle here. We have 40 and 169, create a new target. We have 100 and 169, create a new target. We have 124 and 4. We have 124 and 145, create a new target. We have 100 and 121, create a new target. We have 59.59 and 121, create a new target. And here, last but not least, -1 and 60.41. So remember, I'm pressing Alt to switch from one text box to the other. Okay, so just like that, we created all the targets around the part. So that's perfect. I'm going to create a program here out of that, but I'm just want to add something real quick. So if I go back to my first position here, I would like to create another target a bit further this way, another target a bit further this way here, so that we can go down, activate the laser, and then start, because as some of you might know, I know again, this is a welder. We'll switch that from a laser cutting head later. It would create kind of a hole where the laser punch in. So we don't want to be like where our part will be. So I'll go and enter, -10 here. I'm going to create a new target and then be back at -1 and then go for -10 in this direction and create a new target. So just like that. Perfect. So I can rename those here, rename group, and let's go for cutting 1 to 14, right click, and then create program. So now we have a singularity that we're hitting, so I can potentially move the robot further towards it here. Okay, let's just move that to the side here. Oops. Go like this. Continue moving that to the side just a bit like that. And then press this one here. Perfect. So our program is done. In the next video, I will show you how to modify a program like that, because as you can see right now, it's clearly not what we want. So in the next video, the general team will be how to update or modify or improve an existing program so that it does exactly what you need. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So Hope you guys find those videos helpful, and hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day, guys.